This is Uncle Momo's Music Reaction Channel, where I provide my views on talented artists from around the world, both established artists and non-established artists. And I promise you that you won't be disappointed whatsoever. So why don't you come and join me in discovering amazing, talented artists and bringing it to the forefront of my channel for us to view. Now, my next reaction, we are going over to Japan, Fujikaze. I'm going back into his catalogue and I'm checking out Mo Yo. There you go. And I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but I'm sure when it comes to the chorus, he's going to say it right and I'm going to sing along to it. Once. I don't want to ruin the song. And I promise you, if I'm going to talk, I will press pause. Even though I don't like to pause, but if I'm going to try and find pockets of space without, do you know what I mean? So is there anything that I can tell you about this song? It says captured on Google Pixel. Okay. Is there any vocal, is there any lyrical content? Yes, there is. It says, you look kind of depressed, kicking stones. The sun is crying. Look up and you can see it. I know there's a bright light smouldering in your heart. Now burst into flames and let the sun see it. Look up and know it is waiting. Then the chorus is, ignite yourself to that sky. Ignite yourself as if there's no tomorrow. Enough of acting cool, enough of acting tough. It's okay to be passionate, it's all right to be embarrassed. It may not be easy, but it isn't so hard. Searching and struggling, we're all in this together. And then it goes back into the chorus again. And then it says, keep holding on to the truth, then forget about tomorrow, baby. Live for today and please stay strong. Every day is your birthday, we're just like babies. Oh, we definitely ain't got nothing to fear. Ride the wind and let's soar and fly higher and higher. It sounds like a poem in itself. I'm really, really intrigued now to see how he puts that in the terms of music. But so far, I mean, look, that's just brilliant for what I just read. For me, that really is. Okay, stop talking, Uncle Momo. Look, if you haven't done already, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification button to indicate to you when my next uploads will be. Now, without further ado, you know what we're here for. Great vocabs and a damn good video audio music. Can you dig it? Do you know the film Doctor Who? He'd be good for it. Ishikoro. I love his storylines, man. His visual stories. Sorry, I'm going to go back in a bit, but I was just wondering, because I'm doing exactly the same thing right now. What do you follow when you listen to Fuji? What's your, you know, like, you got, there's always one eye stronger than the other eye. There's always, you know, trust me, there is. And what I'm fighting here is A, the visuals, or B, the lyrical content. Yes, you're looking at them both, but one is stronger than the other. What is it for you? What's overpowering each other? Or is there a battle between the visuals and the lyrical contents? As fabulous as they both are, one is more powerful than the other, even though you're looking at both of them. And right back now, as in just like 53 seconds into it, I'm getting this battle right back now between the visuals and the lyrical contents. The visuals, the singing. And what he's singing about is a massive battle. As though, just let me know. I'm going to go back just a little bit. just a little bit to about, say, to about here. Love his vocals, man. And the changes. I need more practice. Yeah, the music changes. You see what I mean about vocals and the visuals? Is he possibly celebrating? Not celebrating. I have no idea. He dresses like a reindeer or something from the forest. That's about the fifth change. It's so long. I had about seven different kind of changes in this song, like different fusions of music. We talk about it after. Ninth one. So that was Fujikaze with Moeho. I think I've got that right. So when I read out the lyrical contents, it was a lovely poem. When you looked at the visuals completely like threw in a different kind of perspective of his mind towards your own mind. And then you listen to the way how he sung it and the melody structure of it. Then you're like, wow. And then you listen to the different kind of changes structure in the genre style that he wants to incorporate into the song and the way how it was moving. There was a lot of things to pay attention to, which you're definitely not going to get in one take. This is something that you would certainly enjoy for the first take, and you've got to put it on your playlist and listen to it a number of times over and over again. And I guarantee you, every time when you listen to it, as well as it being so catchy and you start getting start remembering the song and start, yeah, actually singing along with him, you know, see my poor attempt. As imagine me after the 10th time of singing it, I'm sure I would get better and better and better at singing it, or not singing it, or just knowing the words. But it's the visual part of it. There are so many questions that I need answers to. But he leaves you with that. There's not one video that, when he does it, you don't beg to answer the questions, various questions, just to try to get into his psyche. And it's nice to do that, to have an artist like that. Have an artist to keep, an artist to keep you on your toes. An artist that's not predictable. I like that. And his background of how he got from there to where he is, it's even more sweeter to read and to find out and be more addicted to the personal character. I like that. And for that reason, I salute you. Boom.